fans, this is Mick Karch. Another exciting hour of championship wrestling brought to you by West 4 Wrestling Promotions and the National Wrestling Alliance. Let's go right to ringside right now. Great NWA wrestling action coming up. Let's go right to the ring announcer.
All right, wrestling fans, more great action coming up again on NWA Wrestling. This is a one-fall match with a 30-minute time limit. Introducing first from Calgary, Alberta, weighing in at 235 pounds, Randy Rose. Randy Rose. His opponent, one half of the real fan favorite, the High Rollers from San Diego, California, at 245 pounds, Ricky Rice. Ricky Rice. Wayne Bremner is the referee. Down to Mick Karch at ringside with Ted Stevens.
One half of the High Rollers, the very popular Ricky Rice, in the ring right now with Randy Rose to kick things off on NWA Championship Wrestling presented by West 4 Wrestling Promotions. And take a look at this flashy Ricky Rice in the ring. Two or three maneuvers into a hammerlock, and Randy Rose seeks the safety of the ring apron.
Randy Rose, a rookie, but he's coming up quick. Let me tell you, Randy Rose is doing a fantastic job in the West 4 Wrestling Alliance NWA Wrestling League.
Quick arm drag takedown there by Ricky Rice into a second arm drag, and Randy Rose has decided that discretion is the better part of valor, and he has taken a little exit from the ring area on the floor, and he tells the referee to back Ricky Rice up. Ricky Rice is on the other side of the ring. I don't know how much more room Randy Rose needs to get in the ring. Apparently a little frustration setting in on the part of Mr. Rose early in this encounter.
Well, Ricky Rice, one half of the High Rollers, doing a fabulous job all the way along. Tag team action, single matches, you name it. What do you think, Mick?
He is a tremendous, tremendous young wrestler. He has a great array of scientific wrestling, and as we have seen many, many times, if the opponent, whether it's a Randy Rose, a Rig the Terminator, a Russian Crusher, a Chris Markov, if the opponent decides to go the rough style, Ricky Rice is more than eager and capable of obliging in that ring.
Quite the gentleman inside the ring and outside, Ricky Rice, but I'll tell you one guy that he doesn't like to have too much to do with, and that's Eddie Sharkey.
There aren't too many people who want to have anything to do with Eddie Sharkey outside of Eddie Sharkey's army. The man has a personality that grates on you like running your fingernails on a blackboard. Crunching shoulder block there by Ricky Rice. Randy Rose again into that side headlock. Ricky Rice has had more than one run-in with Eddie Sharkey, as have most of the people in the wrestling profession, come to think of it. But thus far, Ricky Rice and Ace Brand on the High Rollers maintaining their steady course en route to tag team championships.
Whoa!
What a tremendous dropkick. You know, Ted, I've said it before, Ricky Rice has perhaps the most devastating dropkick in wrestling today. He is up at least 7-8 feet in the air, and what a power slam. This one could be over before it started, and it is.
That's all she wrote.
A tremendously impressive victory for one half of the fantastic High Rollers, Ricky Rice. We're coming right back.
All right, wrestling fans, more great action coming up now on NWA Professional Wrestling. Introducing the combatants, first in the corner to my left, from Hollywood, California, at 235 pounds, Goldie Rogers. His opponent, from Calgary, Alberta, at 241 pounds, Cowboy Bill Cody. Dave Goble is the referee, down to Mick Karch ringside with Ted Stevens.
Already arguing with the referee is the Technicolor, the strange, bizarre Goldie Rogers. In the ring with Cowboy Bill Cody in this one-fall bout, Mr. Rogers Look at this. Look at this. I don't know if he thinks that's an impressive-looking physique that he's flashing to the crowd. If he's trying to tell us that the lining of that ring jacket is made out of silk or satin, now he's looking at his sunglasses like they... Oh, wait a minute! Enough of the fashion show. It's down to business. And Bill Cody is whipped into the turnbuckle by Goldie Rogers, who has really mounted an offensive here as the match gets underway.
Right now, Bill Cody, the cowboy, is on the receiving end, getting raked across the eyes and nose. Goldie Rogers hammering him into the...
Fist to the head, right to the nose. Spun Bill Cody around. And Goldie Rogers, very, very pleased with what he's doing in that ring. Told the referee to stay out of his way. And now in on top again of Bill Cody. Over the top rope, draping that neck, and there, popped him in the nose again. This Goldie Rogers, for all his flamboyance, is rough and tough in that ring. And again, Bill Cody, he doesn't know if he's foot or horseback right now. And now a rake of the eyes by the very, very bizarre Goldie Rogers. But now Cody fires back with one to the midsection and two. Fires back with a shot to the jaw.
Cody's nose bleeding right now as Goldie Rogers goes to work on the face of Cowboy Bill Cody.
Putting the boots to him in the corner. Look at that, and now he's working on that nose. He sees that he's injured, Bill Cody. That bloody nose. Working on it. Trying to take away the breathing capacity of Bill Cody. Forcing Cody to breathe through the mouth, which would certainly sap his endurance in a hurry. Cody fired back to the midsection there, but not enough. And now a savant kick to the midsection and a knee lift. And now Cody showing some definite signs of life here, trying to shake the cobwebs out. As Goldie Rogers was sprawling to the canvas. And now Goldie is asking for a little reprieve. There he grabs the beard. Referee tells him to break. Oh! Oh! Cody wouldn't break the hold. The referee did, and I think Mr. Rogers is minus about 112 whiskers.
Well, I'll tell you, that was one quick trim on the beard for Goldie Rogers coming from Cowboy Bill Cody.
Two boots to the sternum area. Oh, but he missed that elbow. Cody, bloody nose and all, has enough reserve to roll out of the way. And Goldie Rogers now is in deep, deep trouble in that ring. Oh, caught him right below the heart. That'll take the starch out of you. This is Mick Karch, along with Ted Stevens at ringside, bringing you the greatest in professional wrestling presented by Westvor Promotions and the National Wrestling Alliance. Whenever you get a chance to see these stars in person, by all means do so. It's great on television, but nothing beats the excitement that you see at the arena. Mr. Cody with a great drop kick. In on top for the cover. Referee a little slow, count of two. Ref was out of position there. We may have had a three count. Had he been down on the mat right away.
Right now, Cowboy Cody going to work. And Goldie Rogers.
There's a little keister bump to the chest. Count of one, count of two, and again. Goldie Rogers, I'll tell you, he's a deceiving character in that ring. Just when you think you've got him ready for the kill, he comes up with that little something extra. His head is introduced to the canvas. That'll give you Excedrin headache number nine. And Cody again, running the head of Goldie Rogers, grabbing him by those golden tresses. In for the count of one and two, and again, right on top of the referee.
Bill Cody stomping on the fingers of Goldie Rogers. Rogers getting up, but getting up slow. Cowboy Cody with a big fist to the chest and a chop. And a drop kick sends Rogers right down to the mat.
I don't think he got all that he wanted on that drop kick, but Rogers had been sufficiently softened up, and Cody walked right into a haymaker to the midsection. These two, very, very resilient in that ring, each one giving as good as he gets, and now Cody goes sprawling outside the ring, courtesy of the toss by Goldie Rogers, who wants his hand raised in victory. Little premature. Across the ring, into the turnbuckle. I believe he caught that back spring area, that steel piping right behind the turnbuckle. Cody shaken up. Rogers a little bit slow in getting out of the way. Cody sunset flip over the top. Count of two. That's it. Hey!
That's all she wrote. And your winner, Cowboy Bill Cody. Look at that. Rogers got berserk. Hit the referee. Throws out Bill Cody. Now he goes to work. He goes to work at Dave Goble, the referee. What in the world is going on?
Part of Goldie Rogers, the referee Dave Goble in front of us, landed hard on the ringside floor. No call for that whatsoever. I'm sure Goldie Rogers hasn't heard the last of this. We'll be right back. Ladies and gentlemen, my guests at this time, one of the hottest new tag teams in all of professional wrestling. And believe it or not, they call themselves the Beautiful Blondes, Diamond Timothy Flowers III and Goldie Rogers.
You know, you stand here in your $29.99 drip-dry suit, your shino vinyl shoes, you bought at some cheap Salvation Army, and your little clip-on like the little boy going to first grade. You got a bunch of Indians standing out here, fat slob drunks. You got a guy that thinks he's a cowboy, Cody. What is this? What is he? You got this other idiot out here saying he's hurt, that the Russian Markov and the Terminator and Sharky, big plan to put them out of wrestling. I don't think it's gonna take much. But it's nothing, nothing compared to what you're gonna see from the Beautiful Blondes, Diamond Timothy Flowers, and Goldie Rogers, because we have conquered different parts of Canada before, and Winnipeg is just the next step. Tell them, Golden Baby.
Just a stepping stone, Jack, just a stepping stone. We come here for some competition, and we're looking for it. Hey, bring your drunken Indians, bring in your cowboys, bring them all, sign it all on the dotted line. Sign your life away, Jack, that's the end.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Beautiful Blondes, they will be a force to be reckoned with in professional wrestling.
Say good things about me.
We'll be right back, right after this.
Your
ring announcer is waiting. Let's go to the ring.
All right, wrestling fans, more great action coming up on NWA Wrestling. Introducing first from Winnipeg, at 250 pounds, he asks to be called the greatest wrestler in the world, Dirty Dennis Turner. His opponent, one half of the High Rollers from Las Vegas, Nevada, at 240 pounds, Ace Brandon. Wayne Bremner is the referee, down to Mick Karch and special guest at ringside.
Well, talk about the height of absurdity. Dirty Dennis Turner calling himself the greatest wrestler in the world. That may be a very short live statement, because he's in the ring right now with one half of the High Rollers, Ace Brandon. With me at ringside, ladies and gentlemen, the one and the only, and thank goodness it is the one and the only, Eddie Sharkey.
Well, Dennis Turner probably is one of the greatest wrestlers in the world, but I'd like to comment on his barber, who I think has been committed to the home for the criminally insane.
Well, we agree on something there, Mr. Sharkey. That'll probably be the extent of that.
It's a bad haircut, man. He's a fine young man, though. I'm not knocking his ability. Look at that. A lot of spirit. I like that. That's right. Tell him. Bunch of little ratty kids hanging around ringside. They should be home anyway. Tell him, Dirty Dennis.
Dennis Turner in the ring with, I know, a nemesis of yours, Mr. Sharkey, and Ace Brandon, one half of the High Rollers. In control over Dirty Dennis right at the moment. You've had many a battle with the High Rollers, and I must say, every time I've seen one of your matches, somehow or other, you, Mr. Sharkey, have gotten more than semi-involved in the match.
In other words, we won.
No, that's not what I'm saying.
No, that's what we won, didn't we? Am I right or am I wrong? Tell me, Bright Eyes, did we win or lose? Tell me.
Yes, Mr. Sharkey, you have won many a tainted victory.
But we did win a victory. And when we went home, we had the money in our pocket, didn't we not?
Dennis Turner.
I'm going to tell you something about this guy. I might get in the ring with him myself and just whip him like a dog, teach him how to wrestle, teach him a few things. These young high rollers are good looking, they're good condition, they're sharp kids, but I just might get in there with me with a couple of my guys and just whip them like dogs. What do you think of that?
I don't think that Ace Brandon and Ricky Rice would love anything more than to get you in the ring and get their hands around your neck for all the interference that you've done in their matches. Wow. And a rake of the eyes by Dirty Dennis Turner, apparently figuring he can't out-wrestle Ace Brandon. He goes for the rake of the eyes. Dennis Turner tells the referee,
sure, ask him, ref,
that Ace Brandon is all done, and apparently Mr. Sharkey concurs with that. Dennis Turner has become certainly more aggressive in the weeks that we've seen him in the ring. He's developed a unique style, a bruising style, and I wouldn't be surprised at all, Mr. Sharkey, if he hasn't fraternized with you on occasion.
He's a fine young man, and he improves just week after week.
Well, as soon as you said that he's a fine young man, you toss compliments around like they're lead weights, so I know he must be spending some time with you. In the ring right now, wrenching away at the arm of Ace Brandon of the High Rollers. No question about it, when you talk about popular tag teams in professional wrestling today, the High Rollers are right up there with the best of them. The ladies love them, the men love them, love their action in the ring. Especially, I might say, when they're in the ring with the likes of the Russian Crusher and Chris Markov and Rig the Terminator, and maybe, yes, someday you, Mr. Sharkey.
That could happen. I could be in the ring with them. It could happen sooner than you think. And when it happens, it's their problem, not mine.
Well, if you've got any sense, Mr. Sharkey, if that's in your mind somewhere, I would take out some life insurance real, real fast.
I never needed life insurance. I don't need it now. They need life insurance. And as far as Dennis Turner goes, I haven't been doing a whole lot with him. He's a fine young man, a good boy, a great wrestler. But if he was around me, I'd get that haircut changed.
Ace Brandon in control of the ring right now. Dennis Turner saying no. You can see that forearm, that wrist turning white as Ace applies the pressure on that armbar with a twist and down. Dennis Turner had to go with that one or he would have lost the arm. You know, Mr. Sharkey, you and I have talked before, and I'm going to allude to it again. As a member of the PWA Rules and Regulations Committee, I do have to be unbiased right now sitting here with you at ringside, but someday the heavy hand of justice is going to come crashing down on your head if you continue to interfere in the matches the way you do, whether it's with the High Rollers or anybody else. One day you're going to go way too far.
And just who's big enough to do all this? Anyone special in mind?
Mr. Sharkey, I have seen you at your very, very worst, working over Monroe, Danny Shotgun Gage, the way you did with the Terminator, completely uncalled for, despicable. I don't know what possesses you to do the things you do, but you will pay a price.
Let me tell you something. No more Mr. Nice Guy. You've seen nothing.
Oh, and a count of three, ladies
Dennis.
And gentlemen, right over the top. Right over the
cheated.
Top.
He held him by the trunks.
He didn't hold him
He's
by the trunks.
He's holding him by the trunks.
A clean sunset flip. Dennis Turner overconfident. Ace Brandon up and over with the victory, much to the consternation of one Eddie Sharkey and Goldie Rogers. I don't know if the camera picked him up or not. Goldie also watching the action intently at ringside. Mr. Sharkey, I'd like to say it was a pleasure, but I won't.
It's just another miscarriage of justice.
We'll be back, wrestling
Good
fans.
Evening.
Stay with us. Stay glued to your set and let's go right up to the ring.
We now have for you tag team action. Introducing the combatants. First, in the corner to my left, from Boston, Massachusetts, at 245 pounds, Derek Starfire Dukes. His tag team partner from Winnipeg, weighing in at 210 pounds, Rick Jones. Rick Jones. Introducing first the manager, Fast Eddie Sharkey. From Hell's Kitchen, New York, at 250 pounds, Terminator Rig. From the Soviet Union, at 275 and one quarter pounds, Chris Markov. Chris Markov. Dave Goebel is the referee. Now down to ringside.
Eddie Sharkey, the mentor, Rig the Terminator, and Chris Markov, the proteges, in the ring right now against Derek Starfire Dukes and Rick Jones. And Sharkey refuses to leave the ring. Finally, they shoo him out like a cat howling outside your window at night, driving you crazy. Rig in the ring right now with Derek the Starfire into a top wrist lock right away. Derek Dukes is flashy, but there's the Duke. Whoa. Rig the Terminator a little perplexed at the maneuverings in the ring of Derek Starfire Dukes. And Eddie Sharkey watching intently outside the ring. Oh, crunching shoulder block. Rig hit the canvas hard. Dukes over the top. Hey, cross body block. This could be count of one. Apparently the Rig not softened up enough. This Derek Dukes really can move in that ring, and now getting the crowd fired up as only the Starfire can do it, as the tag is made to the 275-pound Chris Markov. Into an arm drag takedown. Markov is greeted in unceremoniously and again, and he immediately makes the tag to Rig the Terminator. Apparently, in the ring right now, the Rig and the Russian are having a tough time getting their act together, as Derek Dukes is coming at him from all sides. Glancing dropkick, but enough to take the Rig to the canvas and into the side headlock, the Starfire, and there's the tag to Rick Jones.
Rick Jones in on the tag, and he goes to work at Terminator the Rig. Look out. Rig picks him up and over.
Oh.
Definitely hard on the shoulders.
Back suplex applied by Rig the Terminator. And now Chris Markov in the ring, hoisting Rick Jones like he was a feather. Oh! Drops him very hard to the canvas, and Jones is taking a beating.
The Russian, Chris Markov, boomeranging Jones right off that top rope. Rick Jones on the receiving end right now.
Snapmare down to the canvas, and Markov working on the arm, bending that shoulder and elbow back. You can see the pressure being applied by Chris Markov. The crowd picking up the chant that we won't repeat on the air, but it's not real complimentary to Chris Markov or his native land, if you will. Tag is made to Rig the Terminator, who comes in with a hammer shot to Rick Jones, taking a pounding in the ring right now. Rig setting him up. Could be that snap suplex. No, high. Vertical suplex. Oh! Crashing to the canvas.
Rick Jones down hard and not getting up too fast as the Rig goes to work at Rick Jones.
Head first into the turnbuckle goes Rick Jones as Rick continues the assault. In with a blatant chokehold, the referee calls for the break, and Rig waits until the last possible second before the disqualification before he does make that break.
And as always, Fast Eddie Sharkey distracting the referee as the Rig and the Russian Chris Markov go to work at Rick Jones.
Eddie Sharkey, I want to tell you something about him. If there's a more aggravating, annoying individual in professional wrestling, I don't know who it is. The man is everywhere he shouldn't be. In the ring and out of the ring. And now, look out, look at this. Antagonizing Rick Jones and Derek Starfire Dukes. Giving the referee orders, giving everybody in the building orders. I don't know what it is with the man, what kind of a complex he has. If he was beaten as a child, now he's getting even, or what the story is with Eddie Sharkey. whatever, you can't argue with success. He has produced a stable, if you will, of tremendous championship caliber wrestlers, regardless of their tactics.
And look at that. Eddie Sharkey distracting Dave Goble, the referee, once again, and Rick Jones on the receiving end, taking a beating from the combination of the Crusher.
Eddie Sharkey just came over to our ringside table and mumbled something. Eddie Sharkey is quoting Eddie Sharkey, giving us a hard time at ringside. Why doesn't somebody just pick the man up, put him in a plastic bag, and carry him out of here with the rest of the garbage? In the ring right now, tremendous body slam by Rig, and a boot to Rick Jones.
Rig takes a boot in the head from Derek Starfire Dukes. Referee chasing Dukes out of the ring.
Oh, into the big Russian boot of Chris Markov. And would you believe, wrestling fans, that Eddie Sharkey is parading around ringside talking about fair play and sportsmanship? Yeah, he's a real example of shining sportsmanship in the ring.
And right now, the Russian, Chris Markov, about to crush Mr. Rick Jones. Rick Jones is out of the ring, and
Rick is on the floor with Rick Jones.
The Terminator going to work at Rick Jones, ramming his head into the canvas.
Right into the ring apron. Sharkey again antagonizing Derek Dukes, coming to the aid of his partner, trying to get him out of harm's way. On that side of the ring, Sharkey's upset. He probably wanted to take a pop at Rick Jones himself.
Chris Markov walking Rick Jones right to the corner and wanted him to tag off with Derek Starfire Dukes.
But now Markov apparently deciding he doesn't want any part of the Starfire. He bails out, and once again, Terminator Rig is in the ring. 250-pound Rig out of Hell's Kitchen, the toughest section of New York. Been in many, many street fights in his day. He's tough, but he catches a great elbow by Derek Dukes. Dukes in right on top, grabs the head of the Rig, who tried to escape, couldn't do it. Dukes in. Big body slam. Rig is up. Oh! I thought it was a body slam. It was a shoulder breaker. Count of two.
A two count, and I tell you, would have been a three count if the Russian Chris Markov wouldn't have came in there and kicked Derek Starfire Dukes in the back.
Now a little double team action on the part of Rick Jones and Derek Starfire Dukes, but the Rig with a thumb in the eye put a halt to those proceedings. Rig, oh, tremendous power slam. That's it, I'm sure. That is it indeed.
That's it.
Eddie Sharkey says, and he may have been right, the referee could have counted to 500. Your winners, ladies and gentlemen, Rig the Terminator and Chris Markov over Derek Starfire Dukes and Rick Jones on NWA Wrestling. Stay tuned. With me now, ladies and gentlemen, are some men that could pay some very, very heavy dues indeed, October 22nd at 8 p.m. at the Winnipeg Arena, when they battle the tag team combination of Ricky Rice, Shotgun Danny Gage, and Bill Cody. Eddie Sharkey, you and your men have probably bitten off far, far more than you can chew this time.
You'd like to believe that, wouldn't you? Let me tell you something about those three pot-bellied pigeon-toed pukes. I got my man coming in here that's going to get him by their skinny little necks, and they're going to crush him like a grape. Now, what do you think about that?
All right. Enough of the games, Mr. Sharkey. You've been holding out. Who is your third man? Do you even have a third man?
I do, yeah.
Well, let's see him. Is he in the building? Is he on Mars? Why don't you bring him in here?
A picture is worth 1,000 words.
Ladies and gentlemen, Eddie Sharkey, apparently... Am I correct? You have hired the services of the vigilante as a third man?
What do you think of that, Bright Eyes, huh?
Ladies and gentlemen...
Well, let me tell you, and you shut up and you listen. Look at these three men right now. You're coming for one reason, to bury you one by one. Anytime, anybody, any place, just come in. Look at this man, 6'6". 350 pounds. He can go against anybody by himself. But now, the Russians and these two guys, they are ready. And you Canadians be ready. Because don't you forget, get off, give it a salute.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Winnipeg Arena is the place. October 22nd is the date. Chris Markoff, Rig the Terminator, and now the Vigilante to meet Shotgun Danny Gage, Bill Cody, and Ricky Rice. Get your tickets early.